Hey guys, Jose here, bringing you another video. Now, welcome back to the A to Z adventure. Now, we return, unfortunately, in a bad situation. So I hovered LeBlanc and my first guy banned LeBlanc without saying anything. You know, LeBlanc is the next up in the alphabet, so that's a bit frustrating when your own teammate bans. Like I've said to people, I dislike playing with Yasuos, etc. But I will never ban it if someone's hovering it. That's just rude. So that's a bit disappointing. So next mid laner, because I know Lee Sin is also around. Where are you? Okay, we did Kled. We've done Kog'Maw already. So there's the LeBlanc band. There's Lee. We've done already Leona support because of autofill. And there's Lissandra. So we have to do Lissandra. Okay. Just to also mention, I'll probably mention it in game. If you are at all confused whether I have played a champion or not, please use the search function before commenting, because I can guarantee I've most likely played it if you're confused. I've played every single champion up to LeBlanc, and I've even played Leona ahead of LeBlanc because of autofill reasons. And sometimes they're a little bit out of order. Maybe that's what gets people confused, because I had to play Kog'Maw like 5 or 10 episodes before he should have been, because of autofill and stuff like that. So please use the search function. You know, it's there for a reason. Because, yeah. Right. So, Lissandra. I have not played Lissandra in a very long time. And I do not even know how good she is at the moment. Apparently, her win rate. Let's look at the win rate. Her win rate is actually negative. It's 48.8%. So that's not a good sign. But Lissandra's Lissandra, right? She does her job. She's a CC bot. You know, you're just farming mid lane relatively free. So I don't imagine her to be, like, a terrible pick. Like, if you enjoy her, I don't see her being bad at all. There's, like, the only reason, like, a lot of people go, well, why didn't she play then? Just better picks. It's that simple. There's just better picks that exist. Sometimes that's all that it takes. So this guy's autofilled this top laner, apparently, so we'll see what he goes. Again, the guy's recommending just play Maokai or something. That's true. If you are autofilled to a role, don't play something crazy. Like, if he picks, like, Riven or something now, it's like, well, you didn't help yourself. Malphite, yep, that's fine. Maokai, any of the relatively easy do-one-job type champions. Like, Malphite is the ultimate do-one-job champion. He's ult people. That's it. That's the champion in a nutshell, so probably one of the better auto-filling top laners, to be honest. But yeah, we'll have to see how this game goes. I like that we've got a Hecarim, and then a Zyra support does arguably a stupid amount of damage, so that's also nice to see. I just realised, if I lock in the Lissandra, we're going to have a ridiculous amount of CC. Holy moly. Like, we'll have Hecarim Fear, technically. We'll have Malphite ult. We'll have Caitlyn traps. Lissandra, W and ultimate. And Zyra, root and ultimate. Like that, every single one of us has a form of CC. That's crazy. That's pretty good. Sometimes you win games of League just because you have too much CC, and they're just like, we just can't kill you. You know, you just CC us and we're dead. Just to also mention, I forgot to, we're in promo now. So we're in Platinum 3, 100 LP. Again, this series, I do it in ranked because we actually get to play with okay players. You know, it's mid-plat. It's not terrible, but it's an okay rating and people are taking it seriously. Normals is way too casual to... It's pointless to be trying to do anything in normals, in my opinion. So that's why I do stuff in ranked. And we'll still climb. You know, we are climbing. You know, that win rate above my head, still positive. So that's what we're kind of looking for. Do I have a skin? No. But yeah, okay. We'll have to play Lissandra. I tempted to go exhaust, but I think I'm going to stay with the Ignite just to kind of be a bit more greedy. I like our team comp, but we'll see how it goes. Nautilus can also do annoying stuff with how tanky he can be. Vi can one-shot people. Varus is very good right now. So we'll see how it goes. So without much further ado, let's get on the loading screen where we break down today's game. Okay, welcome to the loading screen. This is where I use the website lolskill.net. And as you can see, the enemy team have a 51% chance to win. But let's break it down. My team has a Platinum 2 Malphite autofilled, so he's not played the champion yet. Diamond 5 Zyra, Platinum 3 Hecarim, Diamond 5 Caitlyn, and a Platinum 3 Lissandra as myself. Enemy team, a Diamond 5 Varus, Diamond 5 Ryze, Platinum 2 Nautilus, Diamond 5 Sona, and a Diamond 5 Vi. So as I mentioned in the Champ Select, relatively even comps in what we want to do. A lot of CC in both comps. What I'd say, though, is hopefully we can abuse the enemy bot lane. What I mean by that is Varus is more immobile than a Caitlyn, and Sona is crazy immobile and squishier than a Zyra. So if we can just, like, one-shot those two in teamfights, there's not a lot they can do. So that's probably what we're going to be aiming for in today's game. Okay, welcome to the game. So today we are playing Lissandra mid, a champion that is not seeing a lot of play right now. And mainly the reason is because just better picks exist. You know, why would you play Lissandra when Ziggs is so good right now, or LeBlanc is so good right now? Like, there's just not a massive incentive to. Because, you know, Lissandra, by the way, still can do great, but it's just a little bit riskier play, and she doesn't, like, have that crazy one-shot potential that a lot of the mid laners nowadays do. But just before we begin the commentary, just to announce two things. It is a new month. It is February, so that means there is a brand new SteelSeries giveaway. You would have saw it in the beginning, but yeah, brand new one. Keyboard, headset, and mouse all being given away. Check the link down below, the Gleam link, multiple ways to enter. And the second thing, if anybody's playing the game Conan Exiles, it recently blew up on Twitch and stuff like that. I love survival games. I liked DayZ, Ark, Rust. I like those games. I have now bought myself a server for me and my friends. It's called Huzzy Games. No password. Feel free to join. And yeah, hopefully we can fill the server. There's 30 slots. If it's full all the time, then I'll upgrade it myself. But yeah, feel free to join. I encourage you to join, because we all have many a war. All right, let's do this. So, Lissandra, your control mage is probably the best definition of the champ. In what you want to do is push people in, then look for roams. You know, that's kind of Lissandra's bread and butter. It's why a lot of them would actually opt for teleport. Perfectly fine to do on her, like, even now. I went for Ignite just to be a little bit more greedy, because I want to try and get some kills. But yeah. Your passive, by the way, every 18 seconds. I'm not sure if that goes down with level, but every whatever seconds it is, 18 right now, you get a free spell. Which is pretty nice. I really need to be starting to look to attack the Ryze with that Q, but he keeps running out of the range, unfortunately. His positioning looked like the Vi was mid then, because he was about to run down that way. Interesting. This is about to die, so it's going to push in, which is nice. He really does not want to get hit, does he? Vi's top lane. Malphite might be dead. Again, this guy said he got auto-filled. So if he's been auto-filled, you just want to play really safe. Oh, please don't be an... If you're an all-complainer, like... If you're an all-complainer, remember, you're going to be the person that's going to get camped more than anybody else, because they can see that you're tilting already. I don't know why he didn't take that fight. Oh well. But yeah, never be an all-type complainer, because literally you're just making yourself the target to continue camping. Right. I think this Ryze is, like, the weird thing as well, he hasn't gone back yet. You will always see Ryzes go back as soon as they hit a certain amount of gold, which I think is 350, if you start the Sapphire Crystal. To get tier, like, that's your whole kind of early game, so it's a little bit weird that he hasn't gone back yet, I'm gonna be honest. Usually they would have definitely gone back by now. That shield's annoying. Yeah, good damage. I think if we just get late game and they're not fed, this game should be free. Like I mentioned in loading, I think, the immobileness of their bot lane is crazy. I can easily get onto that bottom lane and just kind of kill them myself. So, yeah, that should be the way forward. But if obviously they're too strong, then that can't happen. Oops. First game of the day. I don't know why he's complaining. Right, he's tanking minions. Vi has to be mid from that guy's positioning. It doesn't make sense. You're taking free damage. I know, like, the problem I would say this about playing on two different accounts at two very different ratings is that they're different. Is that that could have just been Ryze doing something really random without actually having a thought process. But in Diamond 1, that means something. It's, I don't know why he used both summoner spells. And I killed him anyway. That was weird. Don't exactly know. Like, that's what I mean. It's just a bit more random down here. And that's why I'm comfortable to do. Like, I could never do an A to Z in on my main account. No chance. Not yet, anyway. Cool. That's why I took Ignite. Free kill. And now he's got both summoners down. I can kill him again. Build-wise, okay, so apparently just normal. You don't even go the rod, which they recommend. You just go Morello. Okay. I guess that's fine. It's just the strongest build. That's why every mid laner does it. I'm not going to use E to go to lane, because I don't want to have full mana, I think. So down, even CS. Hecarim's near bot lane. They have health advantage. They're probably always going to have... Oh, here we go. Go. Bam. Oh, Baba. Kill it quick. Nice. Hecarim played that a little bit risky, because he literally launched the enemy AD carry into our AD carry, but it worked out for the better. Oh, we can go if you want. So what you'll see that I did there was very easy. Obviously used flash, sure. But I used my ultimate, and then you'll see that I didn't use my W straight away. Why didn't I use my W straight away? I was waiting for the ultimate to run down in time, so then I could just use W to then root him even more. Because if you use your ultimate and then W at the same time, those are both of your CCs, and you're using them at the same time. You're wasting precious CC time. Don't overlap them. Just be a bit patient with it. And again, I'm not even a Lissandra player. I used to play Lissandra when she was good. I haven't played Lissandra in a year, maybe? I don't know. Roughly. But you don't really forget how to play champions if they don't change. And Lissandra hasn't changed for a year, so... The only thing that's changed is her item build. And that's... I have got it on my left screen. Oh, well, goodbye, control ward. See you later. Can kill him again solo in 40 seconds with my ultimate and ignite. Half expecting to get ganked by Vi soon. It would make sense. I think he'll want that one, right? Usually junglers take the first one nowadays. Interesting. Damn, I didn't get it. I'm gonna let him push, because Nautilus, for all I know, could still be here. Okay, he's not. Oh, that wasn't in range. Thought that was a kill. Yeah, I thought she was there. Made sense. Battle come and go. I am eternal. Hecarim should run into that bush below him, because Vi could just be waiting there. Yep, she is 100%. That's fine. If it's a 2-for-1, yeah, perfect. No problems. We got Vi, Small Shutdown. Yeah, they played that really bad. Like, the thing that they did bad, they Ryze ulted, but then didn't take it. And then Ryze just ran into me, and Vi wasn't close. So I could just kill Ryze as a solo, and then react to the Vi. There was not a lot I could have done, but then Hecarim was nearby anyway, so it was pretty good from us. It was more of a mistake from the enemy team, to be honest, but yeah. The Ryze, he's farming fine, and it's more me just not farming well. But he's just dying a lot. Like, he's just not caring about deaths. Which you need to. Like, that's a really important thing. Don't underestimate simply not dying. Not really annoying. Fear him. Dude. That was an interesting choice by him to go into tower, but okay, just give me a mini heart attack, it's fine. Are we getting a Hunter's Potion? I've never, and it sounds crazy, I've never bought that item once, literally. Looks to be doing fine. Again, this matchup, it doesn't matter who kind of finishes ahead. They're going to do the exact same job. Okay. Alright, I'm going to go back. Another assist on the board for me. Even on CS, roughly. It's fine. Perfecto! Wait for the health. And voila! I do like Lissandra, I'll be honest. Like, she's good, but she just needs to do more damage, basically. Like, that, in order to make her viable, if someone already in the comments going, Huzz, what would make Lissandra viable? She needs to do more damage. It's that simple. She doesn't do enough for a mid lane carry. So many secrets buried in ice. Let's push that in. Got level 11. Blue's up in 30. Hecarim's going bot. Nautilus and Thingy, they're doing tank things. I can kill Ryze again in 40 seconds without. I might be able to kill him without it, but I don't. Damn, he got me. If Hecarim gets him... Nah. Oh boy. Just go on the Ryze, or just run down. Oh, that Varus ult. Damn. Here, Caitlyn. If only Caitlyn was paying attention at the time. Okay, good kill on that. Keep autoing. No. Yeah. Oh, Nautilus TP. I doubt we're going to have Malphite, yeah, this guy. He apparently has tele... doesn't... wait, is that just a... okay, it just came up, alright, okay. What am I going to do now, Sonya? It works, I'm fine with that. Yeah, I don't know what the Caitlyn was doing, she was auto-attacking blue buff. Probably not the best time to attack blue. Hecarim should go straight to mid lane. There's no one here. This fight's been going on for ages. Okay, finally. Oh my god, I missed that. Okay, to be fair, I did miss two spells. That was my bad. What the flip is that damage? She tried to die of Avaris? Okay. This is a weird game, but sure. I don't know. I just expect people to kill people, but I suppose I need to do more damage too. This is, again, a thing with Lissandra. You need to make every single spell count. No, Hecarim. Because if you miss one, you don't do a lot of damage anyway, so... If you miss one, you're just doing basically even less damage. Which is not the good. Yeah, I don't know why Caitlyn tried to dive a Varus. That's a bit questionable. Your turret has been destroyed.
Ooh.
Will they dive him? Maybe. Nope. If the Nautilus actually hit the hook, probably wanted Nautilus to actually hit that, because then they might have gone for the dive. And you don't really want to dive a Nautilus. Not a Nautilus, a Malphite. Don't think we can kill him. Alright, bot lane tower's gone now too, so both towers and bot lane are gone. Oh, he went Merc? Oh, he's being that annoying Ryze. Who's mid lane here? He's expecting someone mid. Don't know if he was going all in on that. Nope. Apparently not. Oh, that Nautilus keeps missing his Qs. Nice. I'm looking for a regen plant. And I think they're all dead. Yeah, there's one over there, but I can't be bothered. We should not be letting him just do that. Yeah. That's not good. Okay. Interesting positioning. My CS. This is mid lane. Go away. Lyra? Kinda pointless just standing there, Zyra, my friend. She's still not doing anything. Ult! Do something! Ult! Ult! You have ultimate. She's not using anything. That's fascinating. That's really, really weird. She's got full mana. Ultimate now! Save the tower! Is she gonna save the tower with ultimate? Nope. And what? Ult now! She has ultimate up. We can see she clearly has ultimate up. Like, what the hell? This Zyra is, interesting. Just refuses to use their ult. Can you get to me? God, that's so weird. Your turret has been destroyed. I'm gonna go back. Ooh. Okay, I got my Zhonya's now. Zhonya's is kind of needed, because as a Lissandra, the likelihood of you going in the middle of a team fight as a Lissandra is extremely high. And it saves you having to ult yourself. So instead of ulting yourself, which it still does damage to the enemy, but not as much, you can just Zhonya's yourself instead. So it works quite nicely. Oh god, no, don't build AP. There is literally no reason for this person to build AP if they're not going to actually use their spells. Damn it. We've got Zara ult. How do I... She used ultimate. Oh my god, she did it. Too late, but still, she did use ult. Ult. What? That was interesting. Uh-oh. You needed to save that. There's no point using E when she's... Then the Nautilus isn't even on you yet. Okay, that guy can't hit a Q to save his life. Okay, be careful there. Don't mind. We've got Malphite ult. Yeah, we can take this fight. Take it. Whoa, oh, I was rooted at the wrong time. Should we do Baron? That's good. No, we can't. Look at everybody's health. The problem we're going to have as well is Ryze is naturally just going to get stronger than me, and there's nothing I can do about it. It's just how the champions work. So we have to really, really be careful. Ryze is just chasing people. He burnt Ghost. If he pops out... Oh, yeah. If he pops out here... I used Ignite for that, but I think it's okay. There's the Vine. Buy one of these. People underestimate buying an early Leandres on certain champions, and I think Lissandra could be a really good one. Leave Drake. We don't have to. They cannot fight the cold. Like, that's probably why this guy's in platinum. No offense to the guy, but that's a terrible attitude to have. Nobody cares about a movement speed one that gives movement speed to a Ryze, a Vi, and a Nautilus. Like, hello? What? Like, that's an interesting thought process you have there, my friend. Okay. Like, that's a Drake that's really good for them. Come on, kill him. I can't be bothered. Did Did Zyra just flash? I think she just flashed Eid. That was not great. But yeah, all I gotta do is ult the Ryze. He's got mercs, but who cares? We'll still kill him in time. They shouldn't overextend too much. They can get the tower and then probably leave. Because they're all up and they're all going to be running straight towards my team. No one will remember. Enemy want to push mid lane, apparently. Luckily for me, Lissandra's one of the best counter pushes in the game. Ryze is getting blue. Caitlyn hasn't gone back yet, I don't think. Or has she? Oh, I need a sneeze. Ryze top. We should be looking to, like, just engage on them, to be honest, and cracking their base, but instead she's doing golems for some reason, whatever. By the way, the Caitlyn's the one that banned my LeBlanc when I hovered it at the start of the game, which is a bit annoying. Don't know why you would do that, especially when someone's hovering, but whatever. Just look for the ult. That was an opportunity. Doesn't matter if there's the, if it's the tank, by the way. We should be looking to nail the Nautilus if he mispositions. I don't know if we're going to crack this. They have this warded. Oh. Alright. I could not myself. Damn, that's really bad. Dekrim, why did you go back in? Damn, we needed something to happen. Nothing was happening. My bad. Wait, he still has ult too. Okay there, buddy. Oh boy. Yeah, we can probably kill them in a second. Guessing the mouse being negative and saying it's over. Well, no offense to the guy, but yeah, he hasn't done a lot. Well, my mid game was pretty good. If I do say so myself. We just need to do stuff. That siege wasn't getting anywhere, so that's why I went off to the side to see if I could engage from behind. But instead of engaging from behind, they engaged on me. They used Varus ult, Nautilus ult, and we couldn't win the team fight. And Malphite still had ult on my lap. It was the one bad thing that I did that fight was not use ult on myself. If I used ult on myself, it would have gone a lot better. That was so close. Okay, Varus is Edge of Night. Malphite's bot lane for some reason. Oh boy. Hello, team. Why are you running away? Like, this is so stupid. We had pressure on the dragon and they all just decided to just wander away. Like, why? Malphite's the wrong side completely. We're gonna engage on opposite sides. He's gone in too early. Went in too early, I think. In the whole fight, we had zero peel because Malphite went in this way. We didn't actually have anything. Damn, we need to protect, not go in. Oh boy. If Caitlyn's not allowed to do any damage, this game is going to be hard. Because again, I'm Lissandra. You can still do okay as Lissandra, but I'm not going to carry. Like, I don't do enough damage comparing to a Ryze. Or pretty much anyone. Like, arguably the Zyra will be doing more damage than me right now. So yeah, we need to peel for the Caitlyn. Damn. Your turret has been destroyed. This game's annoying. I thought this game was free with the mid game. Apparently not. Because it's also going to be kind of hard to get to the Varus at the backline too as me, so I think next teamfight I might just stay next to Caitlyn, but there isn't making the most of a Lissandra, to be honest. The most of a Lissandra is get on the backline and CC up the carries. So if I'm not doing that, we really... Like, if Caitlyn dies and if I'm protecting her, this game's probably over at that point. Or we should just look for a bush play. Bush plays work to sometimes get you back in a game. Like here. We really could look... What's that? How did he know? What? Got that Varus damage. He's gone the Legolas build, minus the essence. They are probably doing that, by the way. I don't know. Thought they were. Alright. That's half health. Oh, if Hecarim was here, we could look for the engage. They want to do it. Your inhibitor is respawning soon. Oh, they've split. Caitlyn. Okay. Bit of a crazy bit, but oh, they are doing it. That's as much as I could have done as Lissandra. I had an ult and I got their attention with Zhonya's. There's nothing more I can do. Just don't do enough. Damn. This is what I was worried about playing this champ. Oh well. Win some, lose some. I will say, like, a lot of people probably got the comments, oh, this play over here, that was where it turned. Kinda, but this might have been inevitable. We were always not going to have enough damage. Like, yeah, if they're saying Ryze at 1,100 overload, I don't do that much damage. The problem. Oh wait, Hecarim had ult. Did he? This has been a game of people not really using ultimates as well. Which has been a bit weird. Oh well, GG, well played. That's Lissandra though. And again, this A to Z series is trying to be an accurate representation of the champion. And this game to me, it's an accurate representation in the fact that you're seeing Lissandra, why she's currently not being picked. Some people will be confused, like, why is, yeah, like, they log onto the video and go, yeah, I'd love to know how Lissandra's not being meta. Like, she's got CC, she's damage. She just doesn't do enough compared to the popular mid laners. Sorry about that, I went into the wrong outro. But yeah, just to explain, the damage-wise, it's that was a comparing to a Ryze, but that's not even taking account of Xerath, who probably does more than a Ryze, or a Ziggs, or a LeBlanc. All these champions do more damage than a Lissandra by a crazy amount, and that's a problem. Another problem in this game also was how strong the Varus got. You could see his Qs, half health chunking the Caitlyn every single time they hit. That's hard to deal with, and that's a lot of damage. So, yeah. We went 6-8-13 though. We got a B. I'd say one thing you can take from this game, if we could take our early mid-game lead and snowball it, then obviously this game would have been a lot better. Maybe if we had more of a hyper carry in the bot lane, instead of a Caitlyn, if we had a Varus or if we had a Jhin, something that just like one-shots people, maybe that would have made a difference. It's hard to say, but there were just a couple things that went wrong. Damage-wise, damage, you could see that the Varus, you can clearly see, did the most. They're the Ryze, and then I was kind of in the mix with the Zyra, which I said in the game, I wouldn't be surprised if she was doing more damage, and then also the Caitlyn. So, disappointing game in the loss, but not surprising. That's what I'd say to it. So, if you did enjoy, throw a like on it. Remember, we've got the new Steel Series giveaway happening down below, and also the Conan Exile server. Feel free to join that. So, yeah, like it if you like it, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you guys next time. See you.